Hello, this is Bobax, and we're back from our Pikmin 3 Blind. In the last episode, we got a lot of things done in the Garden of Hope, and in this episode, we're gonna finish off the Garden of Hope in its entirety. And hopefully multiply some more red Pikmins, because we did a pretty bad job of doing that in the last episode. And we need them for the Shaggy Longlegs in the Tropical Wilds. So, let us go. First, we need, of course, reds to multiply. And then we need some winged Pikmin. And that's pretty much it. That's all we need, really. So what we're gonna do is get our winged Pikmin and stuff over here to start out. Because we need to use all three captains to get one of these treasures with the winged Pikmin. 64 winged Pikmin, cool. Like the Nintendo 64. You can pull that. Throw them over there. It's weird how you can throw winged Pikmin, because they like fly. I don't know. Okay, use that, carry back. Carry, let's carry Charlie. And winged Pikmin. I don't think we need that much. Yeah, we only need three. Pull that. Ah, no, I brought all of them. I guess I just liked winged Pikmin. I like them a lot. Okay. I also like how they can go over water. It's kind of unique. Oh, winged Pikmin are just so neat and unique on how you use them and everything. Ah, oh, just so cool. Kind of like how purple Pikmin are cool and Pikmin, like there's always like the cool ones of each type. Like in Pikmin 2, the cool one was purple, and this one it's winged. And winged Pikmin kind of represent the small, fast, nimble white Pikmin that appeared in Pikmin 2. And then the rock kind of represent the new purples with their big toughness and stuff. Of course, they're like entirely different Pikmin, but I mean, it's kind of, they kind of got like the little one and the big one. So there's a treasure up here, it says on the map, so let's just, try to get across here. Hopefully we won't have to work with these scales, but we might have to. And if we do, that's fine, I guess. What the hell? Said it was right here on the map. Is this something I'm missing? Okay. That's odd. It said there was a treasure there. Now it says there isn't a treasure there. Where on the map would it be then? It doesn't show that we have all of them. It doesn't say, like, how many fruit out of what is in this area. Not even if we pause it or whatever. Oh. Wait, maybe it shows so far what we got this day. If we, attempt to go back in time. Oh, just restart the whole day. Let me just double check then. Because I'm confused. Yeah, it says it's 15 out of 17, and then when I go on the map, yeah, it says there's a fruit right here on the map. Maybe it's a glitch? Because there was the grapes there, but... Although, it says there's a fruit here, too. So maybe it's just a glitch. Okay, I didn't see the fruit there. Okay, I get it. Okay. So it's kind of required to reset that day. Sorry for resetting that. Well, actually, let's get Wing Pikmin to help out. We need to remultiply blues. And remultiply reds, too. There we go. Reds and blues need to be repopulized. Okay. So we have to redo this real quick. Which we only need about 10 of the pinks. Charlie with the reds. And then Alf and Brittany with the pinks and blues. And then get Charlie back to the base. And then Alf and Brittany will go attack that crab, and we should be good. Okay. I haven't lost the one Pikmin to the sky, and it might change right now. There's like boss music and everything, but I've never lost a Pikmin to the sky. This is a really fun enemy to actually fight, though. Even though we don't get hurt by it, we still have that urgency because you have to do it quick. And then all these enemies are just so stimulating to attack, even if it's easy. Or even if it's hard, like the Plasma Wraith was. First Pikmin death to that guy. Looks like he only likes to eat one at a time. I guess they just did this to make him unnecessarily look hard. Probably what happened. Because seriously, that's why they add the music and everything. Even though this guy's really easy. Like, even winged Pikmin are killing it, and winged Pikmin are weakest. Kind of hate how winged Pikmin are weak. Okay. Okay, done. And we get our fruit. I like how I can almost hear the little flapping of the winged Pikmin. It's so cute. Okay, no blue Pikmin will carry this. Because we need more blues. And then we command them all the way back to the base with Charlie, and then we'll switch to Charlie. Okay. Call back in the blues, because we're gonna actually just keep them out because we don't want any seeds. Let's try to repopulate reds now. So yep, we finished the Garden of Hope. It's kind of weird that there was that glitch though with the grapes that we already got. I guess we just didn't step into the area with the grapes and then it shows it for the blacked out area, and that's just how it's programmed. Okay. Where's Brittany? Oh, Brittany's over here. Okay. Okay, let's go. What enemies is there to really attack? Come on, Charlie, you little... you dumbass. He's just running into a wall. I understand Pikmin being dumb sometimes because they're like inferior beings, but the freaking captain? And he's the captain of the entire crew! Ah, you need to pick a more brave, better captain. Jeez. Okay. That should make a lot of blues. Yep, it did. There we go. Crap, I... There we go. Thank you. Now let's actually get some stuff done. We have some stuff up there that Wing Pikmin can get. It's meant for yellows, but I can see Wing Pikmin getting it. Wing Pikmin are not cool because they can technically do what yellows can do if you throw them at the right angle. Wing Pikmin are just so helpful. You don't even know. You just have to wait and play. Well, I guess you can kind of tell from, like, my footage that, Wing Pikmin are not really useful, but oh my god, they're just so good. Can't get over them. We could attack this guy. Hopefully we can get him good without needing a rock Pikmin. Yes! Got him. No death. How is it bad? Nothing's happening. Oh my god, I hate you, Charlie. Just trying to trick me or something? That something bad's happening? You don't need orders! Why are you still guys are such wimps? It's not like I killed any Pikmin. Well, there's actually some seeds, so maybe I did, but, you know, it wasn't that many. Oh, I love the blue in the onion. Every time I see it come, it's just like, oh, it just looks so beautiful, the onion with all the paint. And I like how, like, the background, you can see, like, the... Oh my god, it's just so cool. Phangasm, okay. Thank you. Okay, now, what else is there? Enemies. Okay, we got these guys. I meant to throw reds, not captains. Now the captains are all gonna freak out. Because winged Pikmin can't, use gravity. Because they fly down to enemies when they get thrown. They don't, like, use gravity, so they can't, like, smush them. Yeah. I don't know how that works, but... Because they just, like... Like, if you think about it, they didn't really bash him all that much. Or, like, at all. You just bash him a little when he was waking up in an instant death. I don't know. It's kind of weird. Well, they can't really do all realistic animations for this because... You know, this game is very complicated and it took a long time to make and program. I imagine Winged Pikmin were the biggest delay with this game because they take so long to program. Okay, let's go! Ah! Okay. Well, no, let's get... Red Pikmin to carry this. I feel like I'm making a little too much Red Pikmin at the moment. Maybe I have to go and work on some other type after this. Because we do have, like, a lot of the day, and I do want to use it on multiplying so to make stuff easier. And I remember it was 7 to also carry a fiery Blowhawks. And I like how the enemy turned the color. That what Pikmin they're producing. Okay. Yeah, I think we made a lot of reds. Let's see. Yeah, we have the most reds out of every type, I think. Yes, we do. So, we have enough reds for now. Let's actually try to work on, repopulizing yellows. And maybe some rocks. But mostly yellows and then wings to help out. There we go. Okay, let's go. Bum 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 bum. I wonder if the armor Mordad came back. I doubt it though. That'd be cool. Cause it's pretty easy to beat. I'm actually gonna check. We have time, you know. Pikmin, seriously, you have to be this slow. I wish Nectar was more prominent in this game. I can never find Nectar. Dun 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 dun. You might find secret files in these mushrooms. That's what I just thought of. I know it's kind of weird, but I mean, I want to look for these secret files. I'm afraid I might be missing a few. Looks like we're all good here for checking for secret things. Oh, we have all the captains here, right? Or is there like one at the onion? Nope. I don't know what any more enemies would be, so I'm just gonna go back on autopilot. Cause I don't really need to get back. I just need to, yeah. Because I have all the Pikmin following me, so it doesn't really matter. But I'm just going to relax, lay down, you know. Oh. And yeah. Oh my god. We finished the Garden of Hope. Last time we're going to visit this place. It's a pretty nice area. I think it's It's the first area in the game, pretty much. Like, I know technically Tropical Wilds is... Actually, technically, Distant Tundra is, but this is, like, the first main area in the game where I actually start exploring it, and, yeah, it's just, one sec, let's just put these guys in. I like that you can hold down Z and do that. I never knew that, actually. It wasn't a memo for it or anything. I just found it by accident. But yes, this area is like suited for a beginning area because it's like the first area that isn't like major tutorials where it's like super scripted. And the first area you get on day two. And I feel like it's just, you know, yeah, because the rest of Tropical Wilds, like the newer part of Tropical Wilds, feels like second area. And then Distant Tundra seems like third, Twilight River seems like fourth, and then fifth is obviously the Formidable Oak. So yep, we pretty much finished this. Next episode, we will be going to the Wild Tundra. No, what? I'm getting them confused. The Tropical Wild, the Wild Tundra, that's like Distant Tundra and Wild, whatever mixed together. Tropical Wild mixed together. Whatever, okay. Next episode, we're going to Tropical Wild. We will try to get the Shaggy Dude.
We have almost 100 teams, 100 reds, so that will be a good team to attack with. Hopefully we'll kill it. We got another fruit, and then we will try. I don't know if there's any fruit near the top, actually, besides that, one fruit that we got with the winged Pikmin. But I guess if there was more fruit, it would say, because it doesn't say the one, it doesn't say there's one fruit left. It says there's about, five fruit left, so. Maybe to the cave of some sort. Anyways, nevertheless, we're gonna go defeat the Shaggy Longlegs, and we're going to, we are going to find any more fruit that we can. Finished up our grape juice. Yummy, yummy. And then our acid chalk. Okay, and then we just drink another. Day 28. Got a lot of reds today. Even the Pikmin now drowning and panicking will try to return to land if whistled on it. Other Pikmin who are panicking. I should probably keep calm and try whistling them, okay. But none of the Pikmin drown, so that's a weird thing to say. I guess they have to put an entry, so they're forced to put an entry every day. Even if they have to repeat some things. Okay. That's a bit weird. Kind of like how people repeat things in the mail on Pikmin 2. Anyways, we are now 100% done the Garden of Hope. Next episode, we're going to the Tropical Wilds to hopefully finish off that area or get a lead on finishing off that area. So yeah. See you guys then.